Nothing lady speaks, greetings all, beloved. I want to thank first of all those who sent me their love and good wishes while I was being healed, restored by the brilliant medical team that brought me back to life. I will always be grateful and forever touched in the depths of my heart for the huge waves of love I felt for my beloved Sinanda, my brothers and sisters of the Company of Heaven, of our glorious Father/Lifuande, and especially of all those who read these messages. You have followed brilliantly forward in their way, in removing the dark cell, building bright, portal-less, pillars of peace, laugh every time we say this tongue twister, and raising the vibration of light on the ground. Their energies of love are felt across the sky, raising our hearts and clearing the darkness that has engulfed the earth thousands of years ago. I am delighted to see the tremendous progress we have made on the ground, shifting the balance toward the light, growing stronger and more dedicated in their work of light. It has made such a difference when they send their love to us energy. We are working very hard on your behalf here in the Temple of Light with the most obstinate dark cabal who have controlled for centuries. His energy loose help counteract the vibrations of anger and fear that they emanate, reinforcing everything that we are doing, creating this energy between us growing in power every day. I'm still on a schedule, complete as others, working all day. I am still receiving healing sessions, as my essence is being restored and the integrity of my energies are gaining strength. I'll tell you something about the wonderful treatment I received during my recovery. As most of you know, I was directly injured by a scalar weapon aimed at Sinanda and me and others on behalf of the Company of Heaven as we approached the meeting we were about to attend negotiate a peaceful exit cabal of planet Earth. It is a kind of powerful and very dangerous weapon. Its use is prohibited in the multiverse because of their potential to destroy souls. Let me emphasize that this destroys souls, not just the body. Only God has the right to create a soul, and only rarely in the history of the universe has been necessary to dissolve a soul. Certainly no one should interfere in the process of creation. You are learning this lesson on Earth as they discover what that is dangerous and reckless experiment with the genetic modification of crops and animal cloning. Nothing, absolutely nothing good can come from this kind of arrogant and dark practices, no matter how eloquently they are disguised intentions. Let me tell you now the result of the attack that hurt my being. My dear friends and my loved ones wrapped my torn body of light and took me to a ship where medical treatment team began working for reconstruction, literally to hang out again. Sinanda sat with me for days while I was in and out of my consciousness. I was only aware of the loving team around me. They use a technique that has been practiced only from time to time in our history, because we, the higher beings, rarely have been exposed to nuclear weapons type in the higher dimensions. However, the explosion of nuclear weapons on the planet and in space can potentially cause terrible damage to the soul through dimensions, as well as experienced during the destruction of Maldek and the fall of Atlantis. This is the reason and why the Earth was quarantined since then, excluded from all galactic exchange in higher dimensions. It was Father/Lifuande who provided the original template of my soul, and was able to provide what we might call the bones of my essence, soul. Of course, after millions of years had evolved and grown through the experience of all my incarnations, so he could not recreate all the complex elements I had created. That's where the incredible imagination and dedication of my team entered. In my case, I was lucky to have an incarnation in which he had worked so intensely for so many years and release the rest of this life and clear any dark energy. Indeed, we had become one. For the team, it was possible my reconstruction using DNA Catherine, her memories stored, and its essential substance, because it is so identical to mine. I was recreated with pieces of your soul self, with some elements of Sananda where my soul matched, and paths of memory Akashic record. Now I'm near the end of my reconstruction process. Although gaps remain in my memory functions, but all procedures for restoration have been planned and gradually being implemented step by step. With each update I am getting stronger and more myself. We are putting all my programs running, synchronizing all that I should be returned to the seamless integration. It is a true miracle of innovation and creativity to see what they have been able to make our beloved healers and creators. The new methods were devised on the fly, new ideas flew through the air, enthusiasm and creativity reached an extraordinary as they worked with all who had been wounded point. Sananda was healed almost immediately and the others who had been severely shaken but had not suffered a direct injury were treated with what we might call the ethereal glue, returning to stabilize and reorganize its molecules to its previous state. We all spent a few days off before starting work in the Temple of Light, which was created in the meantime by builders and architects of light. Within the period of 1 week, the time designated as the deadline for the souls of the Cabal were taken to the temple, everything was ready and in place. As you know, they were taken to the temple, and has offered an intensive reprogramming approach and eliminate the sleeper cell and clear the most obscure mental forms they have practiced. Then they are taken, but only when they ordered themselves to the fifth dimension for a very difficult review process. Those of you who may feel left out, or wanting to have a program like this to you, you must realize that they are being given just that, in a milder form and enriched in recent years. It is the book, Who Needs the Light? And Messages, When God Pinched My Toe and Recent Writings, Messages, Masters here have given them day by day and week after week, given to anyone who requests it, for several years. The elimination of the dark cell through radio programs are just the latest gift that has been given to accelerate their ascension and bring peace. As you see, they have been given a specific program for free and clearly organized to help them in their ascension. They just have to use it in full, with an open heart and reach a level far beyond what we are working with the dark. The program was developed for dark. It was not only directed to them. It was launched by the Perron/Lefwande, with our help and our partners on the ground to be the most powerful and fastest possible therapy program to optimize the chances of every soul to awaken and choose light. This is both a gift for all of you and is the last chance for them. When they ring the bells and, their lives will change dramatically. The dark weight under which they have lived begin to dissolve, because the darkest, most die-hard murderers will be gone. Those who stay here will be souls whose body's light quotient is more than 15%, and those who have already passed the light to finish their review and return as workers fully aware light. Anyone who has not reached a stable ratio of light of at least 15% will be dissolved in the sea of light, and anyone who later falls below that level will follow. He is a merciful and gracious end of a vicious and inhuman relentless trail of destruction. Only those who choose the option to reject the light will end your life here, not only as incarnate beings but as souls too. The whole universe will get rid of the misery of having to deal with these dark. These light workers who are attuned to the higher dimensions have realized energy patterns and how deeply affect the air they breathe. The Cabal have become experts in the creation of each toxic form of psychological, spiritual and physical poison. His knowledge of the chemtrails, has given them an idea about the powerful technologies that we're willing to use. Its physical effects have been devastating to human health, reproduction and aging, but the psychological effects have been even more destructive. The dark thought forms, constantly produced or introduced into the energetic atmosphere surrounding the Earth and have had the effect of paralyzing much of the population. It is a barrage that requires great strength and a great presence of mind to bear. We are now working with all of you to protect them from the harmful effects of these forms of thought. We had to intensify our efforts as the darkest in the Temple of Light raging against the light, sending waves of revenge and contempt for its size. Pointing to all who walk on the planet, but especially the light workers. It is allowed to feel you a small proportion of the acid darkness that are occurring so they can perceive exactly what the problem is and understand why Father intervention is necessary. It is a dark time in our history, but it will be followed by a big relief, and after a pause to pray and reconnect with one another, we will move forward, stronger and happier than ever. I have said that there is a deadline for all souls in the temple to make your choice, light or dissolution. That deadline is Tuesday, 100 hours Eastern Standard Time, February 24, 2015. I remind you once again, this is not a punishment. Anyone who wants to be forgiven and returned to the bosom of the family of God will be received again and sent for intensive review and restore, but for this group there will be measures of average. 100% of light must achieve in their mental, spiritual, physical and emotional before they can return bodies. It is a fair plan in the deepest sense of the word. Free will is absolutely preserved and honored. The merciful and kind treatment will continue for all who inhabit the earth. Those who have difficult lives planned, including a certain amount of suffering, will be allowed to work through their higher selves these challenges directly elected. Those who still maintain a large quotient of darkness will be the next group to try a new phase of intensive rehabilitation programs. Nothing is left to chance, and not a chink of darkness will be left to grow and flourish as well as cancer has grown on planet Earth. Beloved, get on the wave with us. Take note of the changing energies, not just the most obvious news, that are still running mostly with previous dark patterns, and see a change around. They are there, but they have to raise their consciousness to learn more sensitivity to the truth of who you are, and what surrounds them. They absorb the loving energy we send them, dear humanity. By opening their hearts, and align each chakra and raise themselves to the highest vibration of which they are capable, you will be part of the cure. And what will remain will be blessed light, gratitude and peace among all peoples and countries of the earth, and will be extended to the cosmic reality multidimensional of which we are part. We love you infinitely, and we are with you relentlessly. Join us in the light and prayer together as we complete this historic journey. I am your nothing, stronger, more grateful and more dedicated than before this glorious grand plan, along with my Sananda and the company of heaven. Through